blood pressure actually represents the force with which the heart has to eject blood into major blood vessels of the body. And when the heart pumps blood, the blood pressure goes upwards, and the upper blood pressure generated like this we call as systolic blood pressure. And when the heart is relaxed, the blood pressure tends to fall, and that gives us the lower blood pressure, which is called the diastolic blood pressure. So it basically depends upon the stiffness of the blood vessels that generate the force by the heart to achieve a particular level of blood pressure, so that the organs or various parts of the body can get perfused. Hypertension can only cause harm. It does no good. Beyond a normal level of maximum of approximately 130 millimeters systolic, there is only harm, and it can damage virtually all organs of the body, including heart, brain, kidneys, blood vessels of the limbs. It is the most common cause of heart failure, contributes significantly towards development of heart attacks, brain strokes, and sudden cardiac death, as well as it is one of the leading causes of kidney failure in our country, apart from diabetes. Well, there are several factors that can cause an unexpected increase, but let me tell you, most commonly we don't really know what causes unexpected release. There are certain changes that take place in the what we call as autonomic nervous system of the body, which is an involuntary system which is controlled by the brain. So the individual does not have a control on it. But however, there are several other reasons for which an unexpected rise in blood pressure can take place. And one of the most common ones could be an emotional upset, for example, of any type, be it pleasant or sad. Then if the person indulges in, dietary irregularity, suddenly increases the intake of salt or other things, takes pain-killing medicines, for example, which are often used for treatment of joint pains, back pain, bone disorders, and so on. And oftentimes they are available over the counter, so people can just go buy the medication, and that is very harmful because they cause rise in blood pressure. So these are some of the features. There are other things which we don't really understand what actually causes them. Yes, the most important thing we just discussed, that we don't know what causes unexpected rise in blood pressure. Similarly, we don't know what causes rise in blood pressure as a disease. And blood pressure produces no symptoms whatsoever till a complication arises. So one could have high blood pressure for years and decades without really knowing about it, and suddenly landing up with a heart attack or a brain stroke or a renal failure or something like that. So unless you measure your blood pressure on a regular intervals, there is no way to know that you have high blood pressure. And at this point in time, almost one third of the population in India above the age of 30, particularly in urban areas, is suffering from high blood pressure. It is not uncommon even in younger individuals, school going children, particularly if they are overweight. And that same thing applies to adults. One more point that I would like to emphasize for a common person to remember is that blood pressure and diabetes often go hand in hand. They are country cousins. They conspire to cause heart disease. So if you have somebody with high blood pressure, there is a chance that his incidence of diabetes in such people will be higher than the rest of the population who have normal blood pressure. And similarly, those who have diabetes, the chance of them getting high blood pressure is much higher. Similarly with cholesterol levels. So these three things, diabetes, blood pressure, and cholesterol, are country cousins. So if you have high blood pressure, check your blood sugar. Chances are you might find it high now or a few years later. Similarly, your chance of having high blood cholesterol goes high if you have high blood pressure. So a simple tool, when you go to your GP for any ailment, get your blood pressure checked, and that random check will tell you whether you have high blood pressure or normal blood pressure. And once you find it is normal, then you are done for next 1 or 2 years depending upon your age. But let me give you another very important tip regarding incidence or prevalence of high blood pressure. Beyond the age of 50, the percentage of population that suffers from high blood pressure is equal to the number that your age gives. For example, at the age of 50, 50% of the population has high blood pressure. At 60, 60% of the people have high blood pressure. At 70, 70% have high blood pressure. And at 80, 80% have high blood pressure. So that gives you a tip as to how important this disease is, and unless you check it, you will not realize that you have high blood pressure.